Excuse me, mademoiselle, but would you mind if I painted you in the nude?
Of course not.
Oh, thank you.
Mr. Globe.
Globe, right.
I'm sorry I was late.
All right, it's all right, sir.
I was unavoidably detained by circumstances.
Behind schedule, sir, if you wouldn't mind, sir, yes.
Okay. On your left, the House of Parliament. On your right, the Tower of London. On your left, Buckingham Palace. Right, Piccadilly Circus. Left, Trafalgar Square. Right, Lewisham. Left, the upfields of Kent. And here we are, at the seaside.
Right then, what's next? Tour of the Lake District, then lunch. Still, time for a quick one first.
BBC would like to apologise for the poor quality of sound and picture in this programme. But we've got your licence money, so knickers to you.
Good evening and welcome to Wembley for today's big soccer international between England and Uruguay and what promises to be an exciting contest between these two great sporting sides. Well, the last time these two teams met, as you may remember, in Uruguay, the England team weakened by the plane journey and by the appalling conditions, by the colour of the turf, by the colour of the ball, put off their game by the fact that there were no cornflakes for breakfast, were nevertheless unlucky to lose by the narrow margin of 11 goals. All of them offside, but impartial observers, all the impartial observers who were there, including Alf Ramsey and myself, both agree that England should have won, and all that stopped us was that the Dagos got more goals than we did. However, that's all in the past, and today we're looking forward to a fine, exciting sporting contest between these two great sides, and may the best team win. And here come England now, walking proudly out onto the field, their heads held high, the cream of English manhood. And slouching out into the field behind them lurched a swarthy, greasy gang of Uruguayan thugs. Right, the preliminaries are over, and the two teams line up for the kick-off under the eagle eye of that fine referee, the burly, genial Herr Grossfarb of Switzerland. And England kick off. It's Hargreaves, the Simpkins, out to Carstairs, and the Uruguayan centre-half's coming out to tackle him. He beats his man brutally, brilliantly, leaving him sprawling on the ground. Oh, my goodness me, the referee's blown his whistle. Goodness me, the referee's blown up. I do hope he's not going to keep blowing up for every petty infringement. It does so spoil the game as the Uruguayan rides about on the ground pretending to have broken his nose. Oh, goodness me. Get up, you coward. We all know about the blood capsule up the nose trick. Oh, and they're carrying him off. Goodness me. And what's the referee doing? The referee's given a foul against England. Well, it looked a perfectly fair tackle to me, but then Herr Grossfarb, the plump Swiss-German referee, was nearer than I. And the game restarts, and it's a high one into the penalty area. Hargreaves, England back, coolly turns and nods it back to his keeper, and oh my God, it's in the net! It's in the England net! Oh, well, the whole Uruguayan forward line was obviously offside. The sun was in the goalkeeper's eyes, and the ball was greasy, having been headed by those smarmy Dagos. There can't be any doubt in the referee's mind, as, goodness me, he's given a goal against England. He's given a goal against... Herr Grossfarb, the German referee, jackboots his way back to the centre circle. That cocky little Nazi. And the gallant English team are making a gentlemanly protest against this flagrant piece of Gestapo doublethink by crowding round him and sportingly kicking him in the stomach. Well, he's taking their names! Meanwhile, the loathsome half-men from Uruguay are capering about, kissing and drooling over each other in a typically feminine fashion. Yeah, oh, God. Well, this is just a sort of setback England like. An early goal against them, that's just a sort of situation our gallant English lads relish. And as the fat-gutted Kraut raises the whistle to his blubber lips, and the game restarts, we greet new viewers with the news that the score is gallant but unlucky England 0, greasy Dagos 1. And it's potted to Simpkins. But Simpkins cleverly falls over his own feet and allows the bandy Neanderthal Uruguayan centre-half to come away with the ball. And he's going through on his own. The Uruguayan's going through on his own. Surely the 90 minutes must be up. Blow the whistle, you fat Nazi swine! And the Uruguayan dwarf swings a hairy, misshapen leg at the ball from 40 yards and boots it aimlessly towards the English goal. But the goalie's got his covered. He dives high to the left as the ball goes into the goal. And he's given a goal! Martin Bormann, the little Führer of Wembley, has given a goal. If he does another goal, it was a foul, foul, blatant foul. We're offside. The referee, kill a referee! Kill him! You beer-swilling war criminal, we'll get ya! We'll teach you to rape our women! Alf Ramsey, for God! Keep Britain white! Thank you.
Now it's your turn to be it.
Ha ha ha! 500 words on get an interview with the bishop. On listen, the Northern Edition goes to bed at 10. I don't care how much it costs. Yeah?
Are you the editor of the Sunday Blast, the paper that rips the lid off?
Yeah.
Well, my name is Glob. Would you like to rip my lid off?
How exactly do you mean?
Are you interested in sex in the suburbs?
Yes, but I promised the wife I'd be home by 7.
What I meant was, would you like to buy my story? I am a Twilight person. You can expose me for £20,000.
All right. What is your story?
It is the story of how I left my wife and 14 children in a slum caravan in Romford to live in sin with a scarlet woman up at Ponder's End. It is the story of how I give midnight nudie bathing parties off my private yacht moored off the millionaire's playground of Grimsby. It is the story of how I set up a harem fit to rival that of the ill-famed despot Harun al-Rashid. It is the story of how I bought forbidden love and paid the price. There, are you interested?
Yes. That sounds as though it's worth £20,000. When did this happen?
Oh, it hasn't yet, but if you give me the money, I'm willing to start...
The coming of the breathalyzer test in 1967 caught the British motorist unprepared. His back was to the wall. Only a handful of men stood between the motorist and the greatest scourge the world has ever known, the pedestrian. It is to these men we dedicate our film. That gallant band, pitifully few in number, but dedicated to the task of keeping the roads free for motorists. The taxi drivers of England.
I've always wanted to be a taxi driver, ever since I was a kid. I had this dream, just me alone in the cab and a pedestrian in my sights. It's the only clean kind of war left. Well, this is it. I've got me wings. And I'm on my way to my first station, Dollis Hill. They're a crack squadron. I only hope I don't let them down.
What is it, son?
Taxi driver 2650 reporting for duty, sir.
So you're the replacement for Ernie Trubshaw?
Yes, sir.
God, they're sending us kids these days.
Don't worry about it, son. He and Trubshaw were pretty close. Losing Ernie was a bit of a blow to the CO. He's been hitting the cocoa ever since.
How did it happen, sir?
It was a dawn patrol on the Finchley Road. He radioed back. He'd seen three old ladies on a zebra crossing. Went after them alone, the fool. Winged one, the rest turned tail. He mounted the pavement and then it happened.
What happened, sir?
Traffic warden got him. Came from behind, out of the sun. It was over in seconds.
Was he?
Done for obstruction.
Damn those traffic wardens! Damn them! Damn them!
Take it easy, sir. They're only doing their job. I don't think they like it any more than we do.
I got one the other day. Hit him in the groin on a traffic island just by Harrods. As he went down, he sort of looked me straight in the eyes. And, you know, he smiled.
I want to get out there and have a crack at the pedestrians, sir.
You'll get your chance soon enough, son. Put your gear over there. That's Ernie Trubshaw's place. I'm Tiger McClintock. This is Sailor Podsnap, Nosher Waterhouse, Slim Campion.
Hello. My name's Lovelace, but at training school they called me Nipper.
Good to have you with us, Nipper. You'll do.
Writing home?
Yes. To my girl. Want to see a picture?
She's pretty.
Thank you.
In uniform, too.
Yes. She's on the buses. We're all doing our bit.
Gonna marry her, eh?
One day, perhaps, when we've beaten the pedestrian for good and all, and the world's a fit place to bring up a motorist. You got a girl, Nipper?
No. As long as there's one pedestrian left alive in this world, there's no room for love.
Thank you.
reported arriving Victoria. Platform 2.
Right, scramble.
Right.
Lovely.
Yes, sir.
Good luck. Get one for me.
I'll do my best, sir.
Contact.
Contact.
Check for hire sign.
For hire sign on, sir.
Check, meter on.
Meter check, sir.
Gloves away.
Gloves away, sir.
Good luck, chaps. Good hunting. I wish I were going with you. This gammy leg.
Red leader to red two. Lovelace, keep in tighter formation.
Red two to red leader. Roger, Wilco and out.
Request position of enemy pedestrians. Over.
I said...
Roger. Leader to squadron. Pedestrian sighted, 12 o'clock high. Good luck, chaps. Tally ho!
You saw it. You can confirm it. I got... What's up? What's wrong?
Podsnap's boarded up the underpass. Flack.
Flack?
Police Sergeant Flack. Been after him for weeks. The swine. The bloody swine.
I'm making a little package of sailors' belongings. Someone's got to get them to Alice.
I'll do it, sir.
You, Nipper?
Yes, sir. A man's got to do what a man's got to do. And after I've done it, I'll give her his belongings.
My knees turn to jelly, and my thighs turn to egg and chips.
Cab shelter.
It's about Sailor, isn't it? Is he? Did he? Was he? something? Could I? Could you? Could we? Will they? Have they? Can they? Or is it? No. You don't have to say any more.
I'm afraid it's not that simple.
I took her in my arms and held her roughly 2 hours. When I was off duty, I saw a lot of her.
Oh, it's so beautiful here. The war seems so far away. Sailor would have liked it here.
Sailor. Sometimes I feel he'll always be there between us.
Johnny, you know what these times together have meant to me, but...
God, Alice, you don't know what it's like for a man.
No, Johnny, no. It wouldn't be right. It isn't the time. It isn't the place.
We're only young once. Let's live for the moment. Who knows what tomorrow may bring?
You mean you're going away?
I have to go back. My place is with my comrades. Listen. They're ours. We've got a job to do. My place is up there with them. It's not just for me. It's for Sailor Podsnap and thousands like him, and for generations of motorists yet unborn. It may be a long, hard fight, but we won't rest till victory is ours, and the roads are free of pedestrians forever.